showtime.
Is he still alive?
Jamie Cooper. Well, okay, we've got someone that's been to Bozo or saw the show. We'll talk more in just a minute. Wake up, everyone. It feels great out there. What a beautiful day we have in store for us today. I'll tell you more in just a moment. All right, Motor Mouth.
Good morning, I'm Jamie Cooper. This is Athens in the AM special edition. This morning we got Dr. Sam back in here this morning. We're going to talk about stem cell therapy, aren't we, doctor?
Yes, sir.
Meet my doctor, Dr. David Turner, insurance number one man, wearing green every day of the week.
Their colors. And,
well, we're always on the green.
We got a first on the show this morning. We got two guys this morning with the Boys and Girls Club here in Athens. One of them's from Chicago. Dad, did you actually know Bozo?
No, I ain't know Bozo.
That was Bozo.
Yeah, I know.
You know he's a celebrity, man. If he knows Bozo. We're gonna talk about some summer programs they got coming up. Zach's fired up, ready to go. But first, let me do the weather one time and one time only today in the first half hour. Here's Glory.
That's a good idea. 53 to 54 degrees out there this morning, and quite clear. It feels great too. And you know, wasn't yesterday just absolutely beautiful? And you know, we've had several, and Sunday was beautiful as well. What a great Easter it was. Temperatures today are going to be just as lovely. High of 80. Look at that. Partly cloudy skies though. I've already heard people saying it's too hot out here, and I'm like, hush, it just got here. And to 81 for your high tomorrow. Rain moves on in on Thursday with 75 for that high, and then temperatures just sticking around those close to 80s. Don Carter, of course, brings you this portion of the weather.
How hot is the insurance business?
Pretty hot. Staying pretty busy.
First of all, let me give a shout out this morning to the people working the fire in Moulton.
Oh my gosh.
Turned that on 48 this morning. Tragic over there. Of course, you asked about Neesmith Burgers. They're right down the street in the square. Dwight and Helen.
What is that? Three businesses so far damaged?
Yeah, anyway, that's Zach may have more on that. Hey, Zach. Zach. How'd that sleep apnea go?
Not too good. Hey, I got a... They tried two or three masks. Go that first mask the other night. Nurse had two patients, and she stopped me back a little bit. She left me in there with that mask on. It was pushing up on my...
We got a picture of it.
Jay. I thought Jay sent that picture that I sent y'all.
There you are now.
He showed it to us, Zach, but we wouldn't show it.
He showed it.
That's
who
you're mad at.
Yeah, that was me.
Let's go to sports right now.
Get them all worked up. There you go, Zach.
Oh, it's me now. Welcome to ZTV 11 Sports, brought to you by All Star Plumbers. For all your plumbing needs, go to All Star Plumbers. And also Applebee's Tailgate Talk, 10 to 12, the big 1080 WKC. Well, we'll be live from the car show on the square this Saturday. And Joseph will be talking more about that Thursday.
If he shows up.
He will.
Nick Saban, everybody, this was the big time yesterday. Everybody was worried about that hip surgery, but they said Coach Saban come through with flying colors and said he ought to be back on the golf course real soon. And for all the opponents of Alabama, y'all won't like this because they said he'll be better than ever.
Are y'all Bama fans?
I am. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Florida State.
Roll Tide.
There you go, brother. You got it.
Roll Tide.
Yes. Okay, and now we got another story, Brad. Here we go. I can't say, you know I won't be able to say his name right. Chuma Okeke has announced he will declare for the NFL draft. But he tore his ACL, so he might come back. I mean, if Auburn loses him, that's a big loss because that kid can play some ball. Mm-hmm. Go mention a little baseball real quick. East Limestone, they split yesterday, so they'll play A-Rab tonight at 6. Winner advanced to round 2. Congratulations to Athens Bible School. They won. They'll play Donahoe. Tough luck for Athens yesterday. In West, they got beat. And Huntsville Havoc will be playing game 2 Saturday against Birmingham Bulls. So get your tickets there. I heard they're going quick. And the NFL schedule, they will be starting off the 100th season of NFL football. And what better way to kick it off than the Packers and the Bears?
Absolutely.
For the 199th. They've played 199 times. Hey, I'd pull for the Packers on that big guy, though.
Sorry to hear that. Yeah.
Hey, one of the winners in this was Jason Garrett. They own 5 of their first 6 games or gets 9 playoff
points.
Going
to the NFL draft Thursday in Nashville?
Man, we talked about it, but they're going to have it right there in downtown. We thought they were going to have it at the stadium.
Is Josh Jacobs going to get drafted in the first round?
Yes, he is. And somebody's going to get him a very good ball player.
Yeah, they are.
So, well, we started out getting like 9. Now we got down to 3 in the first round.
Well, no, I think he's going. I still think Irv Smith will go late in the first round.
Let me hear it, Zach.
I had a little, but Jamie, back to you.
That's what I'm going to do.
So you cut him short.
Yeah. Of course, Sam's up here with Discovery Medical Center. We're going to talk with him a little bit later on, too, about stem cell injections.
Yep.
They don't even
hurt. You are a fan. No. You flinched once.
Because you're tough.
Bad,
right?
Dude.
That's right. What the doctor say? Usually I tell people,
well,
you were mauled by a bear.
A little bit on this good-looking day. That's been on the right.
That's
man,
right.
People yesterday at Burke's, hey, his minister up at
from Elkton.
Little Elk, what's the church he is up on 127?
That's one of my favorite places.
Yeah.
Burke's Outlet.
You know him?
Elkton
I don't know
church.
Them, but I know Burke's Outlet.
Elkton
I go
church.
There.
James and Judy Turner.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Mr. and Miss Turner ran into him. Yeah, he was giving me some assistance in the shoe department, Zach.
Hey, they got some good sketches.
Well, they didn't have hardly been there yesterday.
They don't have them for size 5.
I'm not a pair of that's me on the right. That's Don and Sheila Lauderdale bought us some boxes yesterday because y'all know we're moving.
They're awesome folks.
Finally moving.
A family found me a good insurance man to insure my move. Country Financial. And the new owner of our house, too.
I ain't the new owner of the house.
Is that not cuteness overload?
Look at these dudes right here.
I said, man, they put them hats on.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah, Jackson and Slate right there, they were the number one attraction at Lindsay Lane Baptist Church.
They had
Easter
going
service,
on.
David.
Look how adorable. First National Bank had the ladies' luncheon. And look at my dates, Jennifer and Michelle. Thank you all for going.
First National Bank, I got to tell people, Sam, I've been owing them since 1988.
And you're going to continue owing.
Truly local.
I've been owing them since 1988. We got another guest scheduled there this morning, the next level for Giver. See Charlie Holly went to school with
it's a good book.
Some of you guys around here. He'll be here. He's a motivational speaker, minister, and everything else over with Madison Wake from Limestone County. He's got a book signing coming up here before long, so he'll be talking about that soon.
Yeah.
Sam, you're a man of many hats, aren't you?
I am. Yeah.
Got it going on, too, always spreading the word about stem. How'd you, we'll talk about this later, too. How'd you get interested in stem cells?
I needed them for my hands to keep working. So,
you did all the research.
I did all the research. I've been, figuring out how to do it for probably close to 10 years, and then started. I basically hired other physicians to train them and get them trained, and then, because surgery and some of the things have their place, but a lot of times with arthritis, you just, there's better ways.
That's the only thing we're going to talk about later. I want to thank all everybody in Lindsay Lane Church too. Fast me, my arthritis is gone immediately almost. Mm-hmm. So, and you say it only gets better from here.
It should.
Now, looking at David, he looks like a fine specimen that could use some getting up and on. The number one sales
so far, I'm all right in my knees.
So far, you're good.
This some coffee.
We'll come back to Judge Jackie in just a second. Y'all, hang on. Over here, set that on 3 show, we could use you too. Judge Jamie, and brought to you by One Love, hearing a man who travels the world. Can you hear me now?
Nope.
Yes, he does.
Zeke will be with us soon. He's got 6 locations.
He's never coming
if
to the show.
If he ever stays home, David.
He's going to be here one day, I promise.
He's going to be here one day.
Well, he's going to surprise me.
All right, guys, these guys know how to play. Here's the way we play. Wrong answer. Right answer.
He will shock you.
Scan the newspapers, websites, and everything this morning. We're playing worldwide live this morning. You guys are playing to win a can of Vienna sausage.
Woo! They did with 6:30 in the morning.
I bet you didn't get these from Bozo, did you?
Bozo didn't give you
those. I'm telling you, it used to be named Vienna and the Yankees burned it down.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, Bozo didn't give you no sausages, did he? I ask questions, and you kind of answer. Okay, here's the first.
No, you didn't.
That new Toyota plant, insured by Country Financial, coming into Athens. They're going to hire 414 new full-time employees. Wow. What is the average salary?
$25.
That like per year or per hour?
Well, both. If you know both of them.
$50,000.
$40,000.
David, I'll let you have $42,890 or $20.62 an hour.
That's pretty good right there, starting there.
What did I make in my first year of television and educational TV?
$2.
$283 a month.
And a can of the other side.
There you go.
Hey, that's all I can afford.
That's what he had. That's how
back in the 30s, that was a lot of money.
Okay, smart. How are you? Hey, y'all looking for a new insurance agent? You know, the legislatures are in session down in Montgomery. What is bill by Representative Mike Ball, HB 243?
Marijuana.
That is a correct answer. Medical marijuana may soon be available. Is that right? Explain to me how it works.
I couldn't even tell you.
But that is the right answer.
Good job. Yeah, good job.
Good job. Good job. The newest restaurant to open up in downtown Huntsville will have something different. What will it be? Right up y'all's alley. You look like the type.
What?
I have no idea.
Pour your own beer.
Who?
What'd you say?
You'll be able to pour your beer own from beer. The tappers lined up in there.
That ain't
that's just
tablet.
Crazy.
So serve yourself.
Well, you got to pay for it. But.
Well, I understand that, but I mean, why would you
first
want...
you check yourself out at Walmart.
Yeah, now you got to pour your own beer. I mean, what's next?
My mom and daddy still don't
might as well
like
just
that.
Go back
because
there and cook your own food.
Because pour their own beer and tap room at the newest Mexican restaurant. It's called Hopes and Something. What is G-U-A-C? What is that?
G-U-A-C.
Guacamole?
Guacamole.
Guacamole.
Yeah, okay. Well, that must be short.
Short.
The venture is using technology designed to keep things from going sideways. Mm. You will customers wear wristbands with digital poor tracking and over-serving prevention technology that cuts hopes and customers
yeah, really.
Off every 32-ounce of beer that's purchased.
That's crazy. Drink.
Nah, I'm sorry. I mean, that's ridiculous.
That is.
No. Man. All right, here's one. The Farmer's Market Indicator opened this past weekend, and it's a good one to go to if you get an opportunity. Right down there by the Cater Day. When is Strawberry Day this year at the Farmer's Market?
Next week, next Friday.
May 4th, just in case y'all didn't know. See, I'm trying to...
I'm close.
Here's the next one. Come on, get with me. What is the oldest town in the United States?
Belmina.
Nacogdoches, Texas.
Some people say St. Augustine, Florida.
Yeah.
Mm. Belmont.
Childersburg, Alabama.
Really? Childersburg, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Huh. Who discovered it?
Can't read that plaque.
DeSoto.
A guy named Childers.
In 1540, Hernando de DeSoto made a rest stop there during an early expedition. They have a population there of 5,175. What famous actor is from right down the road in Sylacauga, Alabama?
Sylacauga. Oh,
golly.
Oh,
Jim Davis.
Jim Davis.
Shazam.
Shazam. That's for their time.
It was Bozo.
It was a black and white days.
All right, Corey's been going through some stuff at home. We'll move on to some harder questions in a moment. What was the most powerful force in early morning television?
Way too early.
Cooper and Company.
Let's simplify that a little bit more. What? In the 90s.
Jamie Cooper.
Good answer, Zach. Correct answer. Jamie Cooper was the most powerful force.
There he is. I mean,
hey, you catch on pretty quick. Gloria found some pictures that I'll be sending out to people. Holograph photos.
Oh, y'all 70-year-old women that's been wanting pictures. You fish to get one.
We'll start out at the nursing
$2
home and work our way across the
town.
Start out at the nursing home and work our way across.
Well, most of the people I used to date back in
Jamie home. Is a hit at the nursing home.
Yeah, yes, he is.
Talladega Super Speedway, that's a big racetrack, about 100 miles.
Yes, it is.
They run this weekend, don't they?
Yeah, they do. Right. I got it.
What other big event is this weekend in Alabama?
A car show at Athens.
That's a good answer. That's right. It's but wrong one. Mullet toss at the Florida Bowl.
That's right.
Y'all ever been there?
Mullet toss.
No, I haven't been there.
Half-naked women. You're out there in the sun throwing a fish, drinking all the suds you can stand. Some people have fun.
Sounds yeah. like a great event.
Have you ever been?
No.
I haven't. Fabulous. Yeah. Well, Talladega Super Speedway. How many acres do they have in the infield?
Oh, man. 10.
10 acres. Really?
40 acres.
Yes. I'm just guessing, man. I don't know.
40 acres.
75.
247.
That's a lot. They said you could put every football stadium in the SEC in that place.
14. How many football fields long is 247 acres? 180.
Good grief.
What is Alabama's greatest gift to the world? Not the football team.
I was going to say Alabama Crimson Tide.
Pilot. Pilot.
Hey, I agree with you on that.
That's a good answer.
Yeah. Connecticut sausage.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Mm-hmm. Connecticut sausage. They make it up with egg rolls, donuts, pimento cheese, waffle sticks. It is a history smoked meat product going back to 1947.
Goodness.
NFL draft is coming up this week.
Yes.
How many players has Alabama had drafted in the NFL draft?
Since Nick Saban? Or
no, altogether.
I sent that story out to the guy.
I don't know.
351.
Roll Tide.
How many players has Saban had drafted?
75.
77.
I said 75.
No, you didn't say 77. Who was Alabama's only number one pick in the draft?
We've never had a number one pick.
That's the wrong answer, Zach.
You talking about Joe Namath in the AFL draft?
He didn't get drafted number one. Who was it?
Don Houston.
Harry Gilmer for the Redskins in 1948.
That's okay. That's way before.
Not only did he lead the nation in touchdown passes when he was in college, he also led in interceptions. Made, not thrown.
Oh.
Huh. See what y'all learned on this program, guys?
Very educational.
Informative.
All right, let me move around over here. All right, here we go right here. Come on, Sam, you're going to get alive. You're going to get alive. A Britishman, for the first time in 30 years, won something over the weekend. His name was Henry Mayo, 20 years old. What did he win?
Wrestling.
Wrestling? Powerlifting?
Sheep shearing.
Oh, wow.
How many sheep did he shear in the allotted time?
75.
How much time did he get?
Wow. In 8 minutes,
maybe 25.
How many sheep can you shear?
25.
Five.
Four.
That is the right answer.
Wow.
He sheared 5 sheep in 8 minutes and 15 seconds.
A little bit about sheep shearing.
Yeah,
really. He said, you look like a sheep shearer.
He's supposed to go compete in that next time.
Oh, you look like a sheep shearer, huh? You know, I told y'all we were moving. Well, we're leaving Athens. We've been here 13 years. And thanks for insurance, David. But I need you to look at our new address. I found this online, made an offer to them, and they accepted it.
Nice.
Yes. Really?
Yeah, can I come visit?
Thank you, hon.
Yeah, what state is that?
It's in California.
I don't care where it
25,
is.
25,000 square feet. 20,000 square feet. Outside living area.
My goodness.
But what is the number one? It's only $88 million.
Only?
Don't.
Thanks, see, this TV gig pays a lot more than you think it does.
Does it come first?
You have to.
Yeah, really.
What does? What's the number one thing it's got that separates it from anything else?
Not the Coopers living in it.
A view?
A view? That's what yeah. It has a 6-car elevator.
Oh, wow.
I agree.
Oh, that's crazy.
I'm not putting one of them in here in Athens.
Can you intro that?
Yeah. I'm sure we could.
I told y'all we're moving. The only reason we're moving is because we got good insurance.
Yeah, that's going to make you
good. All right. I'm going to go with the last question right here. Zach, pay attention. All right, y'all ready?
I got you.
You can win Vienna sausages with the answer right here.
Oh, that's tough.
They might even sign the can for you, too.
That's tough.
I'll do autograph cans. I'll Bozo didn't do for you.
There we go. That picture, though.
What happened at the Arizona Walmart over the weekend?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, you told me.
Somebody was arrested.
Wow, yes. I figured that.
Her son got arrested. No, she got arrested, her son was involved, her 7-year-old son.
Oh. What was it?
He's dead.
Police arrived. A disturbance of a theft taking place in the Walmart in Arizona over the weekend. They witnessed this mama hitting her 7-year-old son in the mouth because of what? They arrested her for domestic violence.
Because he wanted a toy.
He was a bad lookout for grandma in there stealing and did not divert attention to her. She stole the clothes or whatever she was stealing. The mama says, she drove the getaway car, pulls up, you're a bad lookout person, pops him in the mouth right as the police were arriving.
Wow, mother of the year.
What an idiot. I mean, good that's grief, mama man. Is an idiot.
Guys, thanks for playing. We'll let y'all win anyway.
they can split the song.
Anybody that knows Ozo in person deserves to win.
It was the sheet.
He knows Ozo.
Hang on.
Morning. We're back this morning. Let's quickly go over the weather forecast. Just another beautiful day in store for us today. 54 degrees out there. It's a clear morning. We should have partly cloudy skies today, but temperatures are going to be just as beautiful as they have been the last couple days. 79, 80 degrees today for that high. Tomorrow, 81, and then Thursday, rain moves in with a high of only 75. Not bad at all, though, and then things start to warm up quite nicely, and then a beautiful weekend in store for us. Don Carter Heating and Cooling brings you this portion of the weather. And I do want to say, everyone, please keep Shelly and family in your prayers, please. Josh Cagle, age 37 years old, had a massive heart attack, and they're making arrangements now. And if anybody has any pictures they would like to send, John David Crow is putting that together. You can send those to me, and I'll be happy to forward that on to the family. But just keep them in your prayers. It's going to be a tough time for Shelly, I know, and the whole family. Let's switch gears and talk about the Boys and Girls Club. You know, I was just asking, Dwayne's in here as well as Jarrett, and good morning, guys.
Good morning.
You guys were really good at the game, I got to say.
Well, I didn't want to win. I didn't want no parts of the Vienna sausage.
Usually when he says that, nobody does, and we're like, I don't think I want to win this, but we're going to play anyway.
Nothing right.
Yeah. That's right. All right, we were talking about the Boys and Girls Club, and I know Suzanne Rainey, not Rainey anymore, but she used to come up here quite often in the beginning, and we talked about the Boys and Girls Club, and you guys, we're sitting here talking about it. There's so many things that you guys do that I wasn't even aware of. First of all, you're up here today to talk about getting more involvement, getting the girls, getting the, you know, anybody, but tell me what.
Well, we're just trying to promote the club more. I think a lot of people don't even know it's a Boys and Girls Club in Athens. I run across a lot of people, and they were like, well, I ain't never even heard of Boys and Girls.
I just thought it was in Huntsville.
Yeah, but I mean, right. But what we do in the Boys and Girls Club is, you know, and actually we do have a new STEM lab. You know, everything is gearing towards engineering now, and we have a STEM lab, so we'll be able to kind of put that message out there about engineering, about math, about 3D printing. I think it gives the kids a different element. Mm-hmm. I mean, we already in the technology world or whatever.
Hey, that 3D printing?
Man, I was watching it.
Wow.
I was sitting there looking like this, like a little kid.
I know.
They was kind of
installing
it.
Amazing.
It is. Very amazing.
Technology, I mean, that's truly amazing. If you've not seen it, make sure you see that.
Yeah, you'll see that. Everybody be sitting there looking like you're 3 years old, just looking at kind of like go back and forth. I'm like, oh, this is pretty amazing though. So,
what all do you guys do?
All right, so we got two separate instances. Like, we got the after school program, which starts at 3. For me, if the kids are struggling in school, we do tutoring from 3 to 4. Okay. I have some volunteers that come in and do tutoring from 3 to 4. Then we have Power Hour, which focuses solely on homework, reading, you know, things of that magnitude. And then, you know, we rotate. We got an arts program, we got a gym, kids go outside. So I don't.
So
I think
it's fun and it's serious. Yeah,
definitely. And if you're struggling with your grades, you're gonna be in there until you get your grades up. But
okay.
So the kids look forward to it. Everybody want to go in the gym. Everybody
right.
want to go outside. But I think that's the privilege of the Boys and Girls
right.
Club. But you gotta, in my opinion, should earn it to go in there. But if your grades are right, which we got a lot of kids doing well. We do. Popeye's right up the street kind of sponsors our AB Honor Roll Party.
Okay.
So things of that magnitude. So, I mean, we do a lot in terms of, you know, giving back to the community, but also giving back to the kids.
What are the age groups that can join the Boys and Girls Club?
So, 5 to 12 is okay. our actual program. And then this is the team director or whatever from 13 to 18.
Okay.
And he can get more to what the teens provide.
We'll talk about the teens in just a minute. I know that we've got some great questions because, you know, when you get that teen year, you want to make sure you don't get in any trouble.
Absolutely.
But what do parents have to do to get their child involved in the Boys and Girls Club?
Well, I mean, you can go online, okay. but I would prefer them to reach out to me directly so I can give you an understanding of what we actually do at the club
right.
and where you can have a visual. And I could paint this picture that your kid needs to be in our Boys and Girls Club. But they can reach me. I don't mind my cell phone at 256-919-9403. And I can explain everything that they need to know from drop-off to pick-off, pickups to the fees to we're willing to work with you, you know what
okay.
I mean? Because sometimes everybody don't, yes, ma'am, everybody don't have the means. So
right.
I'm willing to work with you. I just want the kids in the club, but also for parents to know that they can trust us to drop their kids off at the Boys and Girls Club.
And it's a safe and a very positive environment. Where exactly is it located?
1017 West Washington Street,
okay.
Athens.
Tell me about some teens.
The teen program runs from 13 through 18. We take processes and just, you know, those years in high school and your first year out of high school, we just run those programs that will kind of, you know, help God along. We run Money Matters. We teach how to balance checkbooks. We teach how to, you know, manage a debit card, how to keep up with your expenses. We work on diplomas to degrees, which is college prep. So we're kind of teaching, you know, the proper ways to manage your money in college.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because that freshman year of college is very difficult.
Right.
And also, we run in a passport to manhood program called Kings.
Okay.
Which we are, we talk about hygiene, we talk about bullying, we talk about stress. We also run a girls program called Day Smart and the Dahlia Project, which is, we have different guest speakers come in, different girls come in and talk about, you know, the pressures of being a young lady at this time. And, we also work with them in the STEM lab, you know, teaching the engineering part of things, you know.
Which is neat because, you know what, not everybody has the means to go to college.
Yes,
and that shows them a trade, that teaches them there's things out there where you can actually make money. How many times do we hear now the kids that went to college and they have these degrees and they come back to get a job and they can't?
And you owe a student loan.
Yes. And you have nothing to fall back on to get out there and get in the workforce.
Yeah. But the good thing about the teen program is actually free. So it's
right.
not like, you know, it's a $20 membership fee, but it's free, you know
okay.
what I mean? So you get to come in the club and, you know, partake in, you know, that experience for free,
uh-huh.
you know. And I think a thing is we do have a lot of male involvement, but
mm-hmm.
we're trying to get more females involved. And I reached out to a few the teens that go to Athens, and they came up with some ideas. They want to do, like, a block party and... You know, but I need them
good
more involved.
Stuff.
Yeah, I mean, whatever your ideas are, bring it to me. You know what I mean? I just
want
to hear it. You know, because I want to get them involved. And
okay.
You know, I think with getting them involved, the boys, you know, they stayed in, but just to get them more involved,
yeah.
you know, instead of sitting around in the house and things.
Do you have? And that's important too. And at the same time, you don't. What is that idle time? I mean, you're gonna get
idle
in trouble.
Idle mind.
Right. What is your biggest struggle with the teens at this point?
Basically, trying to find that connection. Trying to understand, because I know times are different than when I was a teenager,
mm-hmm.
and now it's more social media.
Everybody's like this,
it's more,
on that phone.
More social media, more...
I can talk to you here, but I can't talk to you here.
And that's the main problem, you know, a lot of kids have. They're
yeah.
very nervous, like, once you start having a conversation, but before then, like, well, I'll just text you, or give me your Snapchat, or
mm-hmm.
Facebook, or Instagram, so... That's basically what we're trying to do, is like keep our face in their face so they can see us as much as we see
yeah.
them. So, we also have a scholarship program that we run. It's our Youth of the Year.
Okay.
It starts with the Youth of the Month on the 5 through 12 side. And by the time they get to me, it's Youth of the Year time. It's a $40,000 scholarship.
It can
wow.
be, depending on how I go. But even with the Youth of the Month and Youth of the Year, it preps you for guest speaking. It preps you to sit around and talk in front of, you know, people, job interviewing, just your level of comfort, because a lot of times you have anxiety.
Your confidence,
you
know, level.
Definitely. But it preps you, so when you get to that age, you're able to go out here and speak in front of crowds and explain your story, because everybody got a story, but you're able to explain it and, you know, not have this fear of people judging you or, you know, saying anything.
And everything you went through made you who you are today.
Absolutely.
Didn't have to change anything. Absolutely. What made you want to get so involved in?
Oh, my story runs deep. well, you know what I mean? Just a little backdrop. I grew up south side of Chicago. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I was born and raised in Chicago, but my mom was on drugs growing up. So from that point on, I just had to figure out not why she was on drugs, but how could I change the cards I was dealt and then give back to those who are going through the same situation that don't know how to voice themselves. So I've been in the field since I was 14. I don't want to say my age, but I've been in it a long time. But you know, just that it always inspired me. And then, you know, I know everybody want to help, which is fine. But my motto is I want to have an impact in somebody's life. If they could see me 20 years from now in one conversation we had, spark them to live their dream or whatever goals they had desired in life. And that's what I'm all about, though.
I bet you have a lot of kids come back that are adults.
Yeah. A lot of kids just reach out to me on Facebook. It's good to see them doing well. You know, I used to mentor down here through DHR, whatever the case may be, but definitely started way back.
I always tell everybody, too, you know, not everybody has a great childhood, but once you turn 18, or you probably younger, getting out of that situation, once you turn a certain age and you're in charge and control of yourself, it's up to you to make the best of it. And you can change anything around. You can.
You can make better choices. Yeah, you can make better choices and give back, because, you know, once you learn that, you know, this whole life thing is not about us, so how can you help somebody else? And I think you appreciate your struggle.
Your life better.
Yeah, and to where you got to, you know, from there
good
on.
Story. Thanks for sharing that.
Thank you.
Anything else you want to say? You're not shearing any sheep at the Boys and Girls Club, right?
He took out a spotlight. It was probably like, don't start that.
Don't start crying. But anything else you guys want to add before we go?
Just make sure we want all the kids.
Yeah.
Register all your kids. You got 3 or 4, we'll take them.
It's a great program.
Great program.
Good for the kids and good to get them growing
though.
And the community.
Absolutely.
And you're going to make them do some good things.
Absolutely.
Thank you guys. Proud
of
both of you. All right. Boys and Girls Club. All you got to do is get in touch with them, or if you didn't write down their number, you can contact me. I'll be happy to pass on the information. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back in just a moment.
Back up here with Sam today. Oh, Sam, Dr. Sam. Sam, again, how do we pronounce your last name?
McGue.
Five Points, Alabama, over there at Discovery Medical Center. Mm-hmm. I guess you could say, now, you're a chiropractor also. Y'all do a lot of stuff there. You do weight loss, a lot of stuff, physical therapy type stuff in the back there. But the main thing going on right now is stem cell. Is it called stem cell therapy, or do people refer to it as stem cell injections? What's the official name we need to be referred to?
Well, we actually call it regenerative medicine.
Okay.
But in that, you know, there's different things in that, you know, along that spectrum. So, but yeah, stem cells are one of the things that we do. But is it like we classify it as regenerative medicine? So because we're trying to regenerate tissue as opposed to just, you know, covered up.
I got to admit, and I've told you this, 5 or 6 people have asked me the last couple of weeks at Lindsay Lane Baptist Church, how's the arthritis in your knee? Of course, I had stem cell injections 2 weeks ago, but 2 weeks ago tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And I felt immediate relief with the arthritis in my other knee. My new knee is hopefully we're going to get some more range of motion.
You don't have arthritis in your new knee?
No, I don't have.
You're just trying to get a better range of motion.
But you say arthritis is one of the number one reasons people come to visit someone of your
talent.
What you have over there at Discovery Medical Center.
Yes. Arthritis is probably the number one reason people come in. Arthritis is the number one reason someone takes an opiate, and so people are in pain. So generally, that's why they come to see us.
Now, we're talking about people over 50?
Well, you know, yeah, people over 50, under 50. I mean, actually, opiate overdose is the number one reason someone dies under the age of 50, or 50 and under. So that's an epidemic. But then again, of course, people over 50 are taking them, too. Matter of fact, Alabama gives out more about a million more prescriptions of opiates than there are people.
Which is unbelievable. And they just busted a bunch of people.
They
for,
did. They yeah. should bust them all.
Last week.
We've been looking for years better ways to treat patients, mm-hmm. you know, because pain is a real thing. So we have to find ways to deal with it. Arthritis, what you know is arthritis, it's degenerative joint disease. So degenerative meaning, you know, breaking down and things right. like that. So regenerative medicine is the act of trying to regenerate those tissues. And
I think what most people won't realize until they go through the procedure is how simple it is.
It's a pretty simple
thing. You can literally, if you say it's
really
talk like that, it takes so long. I mean, you can be in and out in less than an hour, basically.
Probably, yeah, most times.
And the whole procedure was fascinating to be able yeah. to watch.
The one disadvantage, and this I'm sure this is people's number one concern, is it covered by my insurance? No.
No.
What happens then?
Well, I mean, a lot of procedures, think of like Lasix mm-hmm. or different treatments for sleep apnea. There's a lot of different procedures that are not covered by insurance. So if someone needs to have it and they want to have it, there's financing available. There's ways for them to get it if they need it.
And when it works for you, it's going to be the best thing that you ever did. I mean, I'm so glad he didn't have yeah. to get cut on and
we look at like the cost of, let's say you have to have replacement surgery, which mm-hmm. you've had. You know, the cost of the surgery and all the different things that go along with that, the rehab and things that go like that. It kind of comes yeah. to the same sum. So.
And some people have such a high deductible,
yeah.
too. By the time you pay for all of that, you could have already done this.
Sure, sure. A lot of people have $1,000.
I know you can't guarantee results.
We cannot.
But.
Nor can they.
Nor can anyone. There's no treatment can be guaranteed.
But it's about a 97% rate, judging on the people I've talked to that just work. I have not talked to one person that says they had a bad experience with stem cell injections.
And you've talked to
There's
numerous.
Not many of them.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, like we can't say it's 100%, but we do get really good results.
But now you have to do your part, too.
Yes.
You have to make sure that you're staying hydrated and not with alcohol. You,
yeah.
you know, I mean, because alcohol is going to
you
not
gotta,
work with
you got to try to be good to your body.
Right.
So you got to try to eat right. Mm-hmm. You got to try to exercise some. Because once your pain goes away.
Vitamin C
is very important.
Mm-hmm.
Nutrition is important. You know, eating, you know, good quality foods is important.
And that should be important to you anyway.
How long does this stem cell inject? How long do they last? Have I got to redo it in 3 years?
No. Not normally. No. The problem I get with patients is like, I feel so good and I go out and do stuff like, you can still re-injure your knee. You know, or whatever you got. So like the problem, yeah, you're not invincible. So there's always a chance that you can injure yourself again. The thing is we don't really know. We've seen patients go years and years and years without, you know, having another
now,
treatment.
Now, it's not okay. just for arthritis and just not for knees. You've had your shoulder done.
I had my shoulder done because I had a torn bicipital tendon, not completely torn, a partial tear. So for things like that are partially torn, is actually a pretty good an option for someone. But like complete tears, a lot of times there's retraction of the tissues and they have to have surgery.
What's the future of stem cell injection?
It's pretty bright because more and more people are doing it every day. More and more doctors, more and more research is coming out every day. They're using it for different types of treatments. I mean, in every type of medical field, they're starting to use it mm-hmm. with good results.
How hard is it to get in and see you guys over at Discovery Medical Center?
It gets pretty busy, but not that hard. We can usually get you in within a day or two.
All right. Anything else we need to know about Discovery Medical Center?
I'll be doing a lecture on stem cells at Bravo Italian Restaurant on May 9th, about, I think it's at 5:30. Mm-hmm. So there's a dinner included. So other than that,
just call your office.
Just call the office. You can reserve it. Yeah, reserve a seat. Yeah.
Is it a free consultation?
Yeah, we do free consultations.
Okay.
That usually can give us an idea if you know, in order to find out if you're a candidate, you do have to go through an evaluation process. You gotta, you know, we gotta do some imaging of some kind. So we gotta make sure that this is the right treatment for you. So there is a little bit more to it than just coming in and getting a shot.
Right.
You gotta find out. You're the
I
right
will
candidate.
Tell you, right now, I am in less than 2 weeks. I am extremely pleased with Discovery
Definitely.
Medical Center and the stem cell injections I received over there because it helped me immediately. And now I'm just hanging on to see how good I'm going to be able to walk from here on out.
Good.
Yeah.
I may even run a marathon for a whole week. If I can do that, hallelujah.
Hey, he's not complaining when he's
All right, thank you, Dr.
Sines.
Let's see you up here. Discovery yes. Medical Center. Coming up next, the number one insurance man in the world.
Yay.
David Turner with Country Financial. Y'all, hang on.
Local and loving it.
If you can't come see me, I'll come see you. Well, that ain't my slogan. That's his slogan. That's what we're here for, you.
Yes, sir. Yeah, we
Keep
always.
Busy,
yeah, I'm on the road a lot.
Yeah, so. Yeah, and what a big trip.
Yeah, we'll be leaving May 4th to go to London, and we'll be there till the 10th, and we're going to stay a week, go to Paris, and go to Scotland. So we'll
Can't
come back on the 16th.
They paying for that, too?
Well, no, I've got to make that myself.
Well, congratulations, you and Irma, man. Nobody works harder, and you deserve every bit of that. How do you get in the position to win all this stuff like this? I mean, what do you do extra that the other guys aren't doing?
I probably work more than they do, I guess. If it's not during SEC college football season, I mean, I'm working on Saturdays. I mean, I work on Friday nights. You know, a lot of times when I guess people aren't working, I am. Stuff like that.
But you kind of will reiterate the story a little bit. Your grandfather was in insurance,
right.
Coach. I mean,
yeah, he was in insurance.
Saddlebags and everything like that.
Yeah, my dad was in insurance for 35 years.
And then when you had a job, regular job, you used to talk to the guys at lunch about insurance.
Yeah.
How'd that work out?
That worked pretty good. I mean, I ended up writing a bunch of people, and I didn't even work for the company that I ended up working for 11 years.
You were made for this job.
Yeah, I guess so. I like helping people.
It's a blessing. You're actually helping people, and you're there to take their needs and give them the best available insurance.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we try to analyze everybody's situation because everybody's situation is different. You know, so, I mean, you can talk to 10 different people, and everybody's situation is going to be different. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you just try to tailor a plan that fits their needs. Find out what their needs are. Try to help them any way that we can.
Free consultations.
And you will go over. If somebody calls you today down at your office right here by Zaxby's, smell chicken all day long.
And Pizza Hut.
Come out and you'll look at their current policy.
Yeah,
may not be able to help them.
Exactly. I mean, there's a lot of times we will run quotes and we'll go over everything, and you know they are insured correctly, or they do have a good program, and we're not always going to be the cheapest, you know. But now there's a bunch of times that we'll find out that you don't have enough coverage, or you don't have things that you need, or you didn't know you thought you had it, you really didn't. I mean, especially on autos when a lot of people are going with higher deductibles now. So I mean, we put safety glass on there. So like if you have a break in your windshield and you need a new windshield, you won't have to pay for it. You know, the safety glass will automatically pay for it. So your deductible wouldn't apply for that, things like that.
Well, driving a Hummer
rental
comes in handy.
Oh, yeah. I mean, just, a lot of times people don't realize they even need this stuff until actually you do need it, and then you don't have it.
And then you get mad at your insurance man.
Exactly. So, I mean, we try to make sure the little things are covered, look at every little thing possible, especially when we do farms and commercial. I mean, there's a whole lot of little factors that if you're not careful, you're not going to insure it correctly, and then you're going to get in trouble.
So when you do a farm, I guess you're talking about every piece of lawn equipment they got out there.
Yeah, I mean, we have a blanket that we can just, pretty much once we know what the total is, then everything's covered. We don't have to list everything, exactly the way it is.
So you don't just do residential homes. You do farms?
No, we do farms.
Alabama and Tennessee.
Yeah, we do farms, homes, auto, commercial, workman's comp. Financials. We're a multi-line agency. We can do just about everything. We ride high-dollar boats. I mean, we've got a brokerage company that Anchor Marine that we insure the boats with because I like that policy. It's a really good policy.
You
for
do
boats.
Businesses too, don't you?
Yeah. Well, that's what the commercial side. And, I mean, we do. It's just about. I mean, we're a lot of stuff we do.
That's a lot to learn.
Yeah.
A lot to know.
I mean, so I'm on. I'll be with the country 6 years come June, and it's been one heck of an adventure so far.
Oh, you've
and
done
it's,
well.
It's been very good. I mean, I want to thank everybody who has insurance with us, and everybody that's going to have insurance with us.
Well, half of Athens now.
I mean, just call us for a quote. I mean, it doesn't cost anything. And we can see what we can do for you. Because we want to help everybody we can.
We know several that have called you and said, a bunch of
money. Right, yeah. I mean, because a lot of times we can.
If they can't come see you,
I will definitely come see you.
And
I
mean, if you can't, you can take pictures and stuff, help him out all you can.
Yeah, we're going to do everything we can to help you. I mean, if we can't, we're going to tell you we can't. Yeah, I'm not going to say, you need to go with us when it's not going to be in your best interest.
You do take care of people.
That's right.
Hey, y'all got time for me to read a joke I got?
Sure.
Oh, I've been going through it. I'm going to share some more of this stuff. Y'all know we're movies, so Gloria's finding all this stuff. It says
and
here,
you know he doesn't let me throw anything away.
A true Dangerfield story about a brave blonde, Todd. And it's found me some old jokes people sent in, all this stuff. A blonde decides to go riding horseback, even though she has no lessons and no prior experience. She mounts the horse unassisted, and the horse immediately springs into motion. It gallops along at a steady and rhythmic pace, but the blonde begins to slip from the saddle. In terror, she grabs for the horse's mane, but cannot seem to get a firm grip. She tries and tries, but she cannot seem to get that grip. She tries to throw her arms around the horse's neck, but she slides down the side of the horse anyway. It continues to gallop away. As the horse gallops, seemingly oblivious to the slipping rider, finally, giving her last frail grip, she leaps away from the horse and tries to throw herself to safety. Unfortunately, her foot has become entangled in the stirrup, and now she is at the mercy of the horse's pounding hooves. As her head strikes the ground over and over again, and her head is battered against the ground, she is mere moments away from unconsciousness when, fortunately, the Walmart manager sees her and unplugs the horse.
I was waiting for that.
Anyway, I'm entertained at home all the time.
You know who sent me that? In 1999, at 9:32 a.m., Roy Story of Story Lee Furniture, the owner, sends me some of the jokes I can't read on there.
Yeah, really.
I will make them up and read them to you later. We're going to be reminiscing a little bit because there's a bunch of stuff that Gloria found, too. So I'll be autographing some old pictures and stuff I'm trying to get rid of. Anyway, thank y'all for getting done with us. We'll see y'all later this week.
Bye.